Vegas, dude.
Hi, everybody. This is Brett Jenny with Simply Vegas, and I am here today to kick a little knowledge to you guys. I'm sitting down with Greg, a certified home inspector. Greg, tell us a little bit about your history. How long you've been doing it, what you did before the home inspection?
Well, actually, Brett, I come from the building industry. Well, my whole family does. It's like build bloods.
Oh, okay.
So, My grandfather, a few generations, multi-generational. I'm actually third generation, born and raised in a family-owned and operated custom cabinet shop. Started out in Northern California. My dad went into that business. I was brought up in that business, and we were general contractors. And
wow.
Custom cabinets was our mainframe of our shop. So, and we did a little bit of everything. So we had done a lot of work in Northern California, PG&E, University of Santa Clara. Lots of residential too.
Okay.
So both residential and commercial.
Okay.
Time goes on. We moved the cabinet shop to Lake Havasu. I wind up in here in Las Vegas, and went to work out on the Hoover Dam expansion project as a union carpenter. So
you've paid your dues.
I paid my dues.
And
essentially, after a while, I traded in the hammer for a camera.
So, gotcha.
You know, as a builder. Ran into a lot of frustrations where I would have an inspector come out and make a frivolous claim.
Okay.
And it would cost me time and money.
Yeah.
And so I saw a need for certain.
Okay.
And then I thought, well, if someone could actually make, you know, a dollar providing a service that's definitely needed.
Without a doubt.
Get into it. And so we started up our inspection firm about 3 years ago.
Okay.
So okay. Was a subcontractor here in the Valley in the local home building industry for over 2 decades before.
So, very well qualified, to say the least. You've seen a building or two.
Yeah. Sometimes, we're always our own worst critic, right?
Yeah.
Because we care so much.
Yep.
We want to do such a good job. So, sometimes I don't see it as I'm so overqualified. I just see it as everyone else is really underqualified.
Yeah.
There's a lot of it out there.
You know what? I look at it the same way with real estate. It's our job as the professionals to educate people and let them know, which is kind of the reason why I wanted to have Greg in today. The two most important things once you have an accepted offer are the appraisal with the lender and the home inspection. Those, if a deal is going to fall apart or go sideways or need to be reworked, it always comes down to an issue with the appraisal or an issue with the home inspection. So I wanted to have Greg's my personal home inspector. I use him for everything. I try to use him on all my deals, everything that I can, because of his experience. And he's just seen a lot. So I guess, what are some of the main questions that the average buyer has when we get in the contract, you come over for a home inspection? I mean, I'm sure you've seen people from Nervous Nancy to Laid Back Larry. And everything in between. What are some of the most common things that people are asking you about or come up that you see?
Sure. We definitely see it all. So like you're saying, and it's going to depend on the instance as to what those most common questions are.
Okay.
Whether is it existing inventory? Is it new construction? Is it a question coming from a seller? So if we're in an existing inventory and the house is occupied, one of the questions we always get from the seller they're pretty nervous.
Yeah.
Nancy. They're on pins and needles.
Yeah, of course.
So their big question is, well, do we pass? Do we fail? And so when you think of the term inspection, right, everyone thinks that kind of means pass or fail.
Mm.
It's not necessarily the case because inspectors of structures here in Southern Nevada, we're not an authority having jurisdiction. So it's not like I can come into a home and revoke a certificate of occupancy or anything.
Gotcha.
Like that.
So
there's no pass or fail. There's just us coming in and saying, hey, we're making observations. We're stating an opinion based on those observations
that
we make during the course of the inspection that illustrates the current condition of that property. We help identify areas that need attention and which areas need a little bit more attention and prioritize over others.
Gotcha.
And then the next question I get from buyers, usually afterwards, is, well, they have to fix that, right?
I know.
Yeah. So well, they have to fix that, right? And can I ask for that to be fixed?
Yeah.
And what can I ask for? And what do they have to fix? And so, and my answer is always the same. It's typically going to be along the lines that, well, you can ask for whatever you want, and then they can tell you they're not going to do anything.
Yeah. Correct.
Because this isn't a pass or fail. This is just
what this we can
the,
work
this
out.
This is the current condition of the property. These are areas that need attention. And from there, it's a negotiation, and you want to work with your real estate professional, which would be where you come in, who helps steer them in the area. I always tell people all the time, I say, look, yes, you can ask for this blind that's sitting a little crooked, that has a crack in it. You can ask for that to be repaired. But sometimes, do we want to focus our attention? Do we want to worry about that blind that's cracked? Or do we want to focus our attention and worry more about the roof tile that's cracked?
I mean, it's not your job as the inspector to let the buyer or the seller know what needs to happen, It's simply your job to inspect and inform.
Right.
Now, what happens after that part is where I come into play as the realtor and the negotiations and all those things. I think the main things that people want to know, which is my job to let them know and educate them. But what's great about you is you're there to back me up, I guess, or at least say, listen, these are things I always go and do a home inspection, letting buyers know this. We want to look for things that could be code violations or things that are just straight up broken and need repaired. What we don't want to do are look for cosmetic issues, a chip in this, a crack in that, whatever it is, because I mean, unless, even a brand new house, you're going to find nothing's perfect.
Yes.
So if it's a leaking faucet and it's coming through or whatever, obviously, yes, that should be fixed. That's a quick fix. No big deal. But I've had some people say, oh, the stucco on the outside of the house is cracked. Well, we're in the desert.
Yeah, I see it on every house.
It happens on every single house. The most common issue that I see as a realtor, and I'm sure obviously you do as well as the inspector, are something with a roof with tile. There's usually cracked tile or missing tile or something.
Well, we have a pretty harsh environment out here.
We do.
So, and you know, we get pretty hot. We get kind of cold. I mean, 30 degrees to me, that's pretty cool. So, and 120 degrees. And so,
I'm from Wisconsin. It's -5.
Yeah, today. I've never experienced that. So I don't know. I mean, I'm curious, but yeah, most people don't want to.
It looks good from the view.
In the summertime, it's like 110 degrees out. Right?
Yeah,
we're triple digits. Okay, and we don't like that. So some people are running their air conditioners like nonstop, keeping it 70 degrees. Beefkeeper 2000 inside their house. And so we have that temperature difference, hot outside, cold inside.
Yep.
We got thermal transfer, there's movement, expansion, we got condensation. These are all things that are just hard. And then we have our monsoons. So these are things that are really hard on the stucco. The stucco is going to crack. The tiles are going to crack. We have a lot of golf courses out here.
Yeah.
So golf balls, bogeys, people are slicing off the fairway.
All right, Greg, I appreciate your time today. I think what we're going to do, what we discussed before, is kind of head out into the field next time and actually take a look at different properties and have Greg go through different issues, things that can be fixed easily, point out different common things that come up in a home inspection.
Sure, I think that'd be a great idea. We could be on a project and, right there standing in front of a hot water heater and talking about some of the common issues that
I can just show up for one of your home inspections, period, and just show up live and just.
Better yet, you could get a deal in escrow.
I like that one better because that's more money for me involved on that one.
So, yeah, we'll take it from the field. That'd be good because it'll be live from the trenches.
Awesome.
So, and we can actually see the product as we're talking about the product and the areas of concern.
I think that's a great idea. I mean, I know personally I learned best by hands-on and actually seeing instead of just what's on paper. So I think that's a great idea. Greg, absolutely. I appreciate your time.
Absolutely appreciate it.
Everybody, please like and subscribe down below. I definitely appreciate the love. Thank you so much. Enjoy your day.